The John Wick franchise has endeared itself to millions of action movie lovers worldwide. Of course, it's down to the filmmaking skills of the producers and the dexterity and professionalism with which Keanu Reeves has played the role of John Wick, a brutal, titular anti-hero assassin who engages his opponents in all types of intense fights at every opportunity he gets. This includes fist fights, sword fights, gun fights, and even pencil fights. And three movies down the line, moviegoers cannot seem to get enough of the impressive fighting scenes the franchise offers. But of course, some scenes have been more intense and exceptional than others. So join us in today's video as we rewind the movie reels to reveal the top 10 John Wick fight scenes we've watched. There's no doubt what to expect when you pit two assassins against each other. At the very least, you should expect an entertaining brawl and a lot of damaged commodities, which could sometimes include human life. Well, this wasn't the case when John Wick and Cassian squared off in a street fight in John Wick Chapter 2, but the scene was entertaining nonetheless. Their rivalry kicked off when John Wick killed Cassian's boss, Gianna Antonio, in cold blood. And having sworn to Antonio, Cassian set off to get revenge. The first encounter was a fierce one-versus-one shootout that occurred along cobblestone streets in Italy. As one of the few people that can match up to John Wick, it was only a matter of time before both fighters got into close-quarter combat, which happened just after the pair rolled down a massive series of steps. Eventually, they smashed through the window of the famous Italian Continental as the brawl ended in a stalemate. Toward the end of Chapter 2, both fighters squared off again, this time in New York City. After exchanging silent gunfire, they moved their fight into the subway, where John Wick emerged the winner, but Cassian managed to stay alive. Still in Chapter 2, John Wick displayed some sleek fighting skills as he trailed Santino D'Antonio. The very last shootout of this chapter happened at an exhibition tagged Reflection of the Soul in the New York City Art Museum. Wick engaged fighters loyal to the high table member in a fierce gunfight, but the intensity sort of reduced as he made his way to the Hall of Shifting Mirrors. This scene made for an interesting watch, thanks to the multiple reflections and the maze-like features of the place itself, which were brilliantly integrated into the fight choreography. But even more impressive, John Wick delivered some breathtaking moves that added more intensity to the scene. On one occasion, the world-famous assassin had to calculate the trajectory of several reflections to plant a bullet in the head of one of the villains, who was tougher and more equipped than most of the adversaries that Wick has had to face. On another occasion, he leaped through a wall of mirrors to tackle a thug before proceeding to have a one-on-one fight with Santino's mute bodyguard, Ares. Chapter 3 took off where Chapter 2 left off, as John went on the run as the clock ticked down to him being an excommunicado in the underworld. One cab ride later, John was hunting down an assassin in the New York Public Library. This unusually tall assassin role was played by NBA star Boban Marjanovic, who starred as Ernest, but a couple of punches and arm bars were thrown around. The face-off was quite brief, but it set the pace for the threequel that was in store for fans. Interestingly, the producers doused some of the tension with some brilliant comical acting by Ernest. The incredible showdown at the Red Circle nightclub remains one of the most enjoyable highlights of the first John Wick. Not just in terms of the fighting, but also in terms of body counts. By our estimates, this brutal shooting episode is the longest action scene in the movie. Ironically, it is also the scene with the most variety and the foundation of which everything else about the movie was built. It all starts when John Wick receives information that Losef, his number one target at the time, is seeking refuge in the heavily guarded Red Circle nightclub. Uncharacteristically, John decides to spare the guard at the door. However, the thugs on the club's lower level area are not spared as the actor continues to trail his prey. Eventually, John Wick spotted Levi in the bathhouse and could have taken him out from a safe distance. But somehow he stalled, allowing Lee to escape temporarily. Consequently, an extended shootout ensued right from the bathhouse all the way to the dance floor. This action-packed sequence drew to a close with John squaring up against Kirill, a renowned thug loyal to Viggo. Here we see one of the best weapons showdowns in the entire John Wick franchise, and perhaps the biggest threat that John Wick himself has had to deal with. The New York Continental Hotel had just been decimated, and the Judicator sent a well-equipped army with his armored vehicles after John Wick and Winston. But as always, Wick was equal to the task, and luckily for him, he had armor-piercing shotguns. Wick brings out the big guns, shotguns, that are strong enough to burst through bulletproof armor. The fighting started off in the lobby, where John Wick was able to shoot down these heavily armored henchmen. Next, he proceeded to the hotel basement, where the real fighting happened. Wick pulled out his shotgun loaded with armor-piercing shells and sprayed every opponent in sight. In another scene, he squared up against a guard underwater before returning to the surface to continue his killing spree. He shot multiple rounds of armor-piercing bullets, and with every shot, he moved closer and closer to his adversaries to deliver brutal headshots even through the armor. The entire scene is wholesome and features everything that you'd expect to see. In fact, at some point, John Wick threw his empty gun at one of the guards before using him as a human shield. And for the first time, we saw Sharon, the hotel concierge, display some of his skills to protect the hotel. The hand-to-hand combat depicted here is one of the most brutal scenes in the franchise. From the choreography to the cinematography, everything was absolutely spot on. It starts with John Wick being declared an ex-incommunicado and running into an abandoned knife shop where he displays his sublime skills with sharp objects. Knives were flying all over the place and the thugs were getting stabbed in their chest and on their faces. And we even watched a close-up of John Wick stabbing a thug in the eye. And without any cuts or edits, viewers watched the final shot in all its glory. In the opening act of John Wick Chapter 3, we saw the horse foo scene, which was no doubt exciting, But the introduction of the dog food scene later on in the film ups the ante even further. Here, John traveled across continents to seek Sophia's help as a gunfight erupted in the black market of Casablanca. Halle Berry, who played the role of Sophia in the scene, had to undergo several months of intense training, which was clear for all to see. John Wick also contributes to the fun and action with his superb handling of a handgun and knife, and his agility in chasing after two armed thugs. However, the real stars of the sequence are Sophia's two Belgian Malinois attack dogs, who performed a series of stunts to wow the viewers. Having made his way into Gianno D'Antonio's private chambers to murder the High Table member, Wick needed to navigate the catacombs underneath the streets of Rome to escape. Having planned ahead, this is where he planted several stacks of lethal weapons. However, to get here, he must first find a way to pass through a crowded concert, albeit quietly, but we all know that was never going to happen. As the Nostalgia Band performed, John Wick shot a man dead on stage and was applauded by the spectators, who mistook this for part of the show. The fighting then moves from the backstage to center stage and into the packed audience before John escapes into the catacombs. Overall, the sequence looked very similar to the Red Circle sequence, except with a much larger body count. One of the main highlights of the action-packed John Wick Chapter 3 is the rain-slicked motorcycle chase that actually started with Wick riding on a horse to dodge and evade sword-wielding opponents riding on motorbikes. Ordinarily, one would imagine that having a long knife in a fierce, high-speed gunfight would be a drawback. But that's not the case here. Instead, this supposed disadvantage eventually became one of the ingredients that made the sequence more entertaining. It forced the filmmakers to be more creative, not just with finishing moves, but also the camera angles, which made the sequence even more interesting.
Put your weapon down.
He's excommunicado.
I'd like to see the manager.
John Wick was particularly active in this sequence as he bullies his way through the entrance into the subway. It's actually an open season after Satino calls in the hit on John Wick, and several assassins were keen to cash in on it, even as Cassian remained on his tail. Expectedly, John survived the wave of attacks and even successfully fought off an assassin about the size of a sumo wrestler before tackling Cassian.
You pull it out, you will bleed and you will die.
This is the end of the line.